I've had it. Tonight, I have had it. I know exactly what these sick freaks are doing. I cannot believe I have withstood years of freaking psychological torture and mind invasion. Even this damn group that's doing this to me, this cult, says they can't believe that I've become, they said, more angelic instead of evil, if you just knew the kind of experiments they're conducting. I had, after they were attacking me today in my house, making me feel like I was near death, and then telling me on the internet they were making me blind. They're sadists. I did a video. And then I was feeling ultimate peace through God. I was feeling such an inner peace because that's typically who I am. I love to feel like I'm in God's realm, and I have to keep myself calm in today's world with all these attacks that I'm facing because I feel the Holy Spirit. But the Holy Spirit is always there. But these weapons that they're turning on me tonight and other nights damage your brain so bad. And there's like a hissing sound, but I actually question if they aren't using their own thoughts or telepathy or freaking demons to attack a person. They tell me they're wearing so many hoes in my soul, and then this like special person's just going to come and take me to hell. Well, you sick psychopaths, I'm going to turn it right back on you. Tonight's the first time I knew I could. And as they turn these weapons on me and they start firing off these demons at me and trying to destroy my brain, I just said, strike them. So they weaken me all the time, all of these years when they were torturing me. This is military too. They would bring up my stepdaughter Tava's picture. It was a form of trying to use my power, use my brain, and possess me. And after they kept me in this sick torture program for so freaking long, when my body was given out, they approached my stepkids. Then they tried to use them as a tool to try to motivate me to keep fighting for my life and for my soul. But I know God speaks to me all the time. And when these weapons are on, I feel like a total bitch because it makes me in so much pain and pressure in my brain that it almost makes you feel like you're surrendering yourself to the dark side because you feel you have no force left to fight them. But God reassures me. He sends me doves and everything. He reassures me he's completely in charge. He has full charge. It's like a dark cloak they have, like their stupid hoods that make you think you're in darkness or they're over. I mean, I don't feel like I'm in darkness, but a lot of people do. They think they've got some control. The hood is over their eyes, not the victims. Because God knows everything they do. He sees it. And tonight is the last straw. First, they're trying to send me out of my home, but when they freaking attack my brain again, when I'm feeling so close to God to try to destroy that connection, thinking if they destroy my mind, Lucifer has power. They are freaking kids because God has all the power. God is always in control, always. You can play your little game of illusion and masquerade, you little wimps. Gang women and children and try to steal people. So, oh, and you know another thing I think these people are linked to? I remember watching a case file on like forensic files or something a long time ago on a educational channel. And they had something that was highly interesting. It was a guy who was a vampire who was going along abducting women, drinking their blood, and beheading some. But he was burying the people's heads along the power lines. First thing I thought was CIA or something to do with government because it had something to do with electric companies. Well, it turns out he had been contracted by the CIA. And after he was arrested, after he killed those women as a vampire, he died before he could go to trial. And I can see this, and I know that Jeffrey Dahmer made his victim watch Star Wars before he killed him and decapitated him. There have been other crimes too that all seem to be linked to people that are coming from out of the country and do these stupid rituals and then they leave. I think that this group that's doing this to me may have gotten so upset when I started researching the criminals that were stealing from me. And they started saying, oh, you went down the rabbit hole. Well, they are having a ball playing with me because they said I possess some gift. You know, they just say that I have some power through God. Sometimes they say the Antichrist. This isn't the Antichrist. It's just a very keen perception. I do have psychic power, and I know it comes directly from God. But I know I'm immune to evil, so they can keep playing all they want, but they are driving me insane. And they told me today, ha ha ha, because you won't do what we say, we're going to steal everything and give your house to Tava and all this bullshit. And it might have something to do with Chris's connections and Tava's connections with government, because Alex DeSico was their mom's best friend, and he was Jenna Bush's bodyguard, he said, temporarily, Secret Service. And Chris did tell his father in a letter he was going to meet a dark group and our life was going to change. So who knows? Who knows if the film people that were stealing from me pursued them, or if they found out that this film company was stealing from me. I think that this group is so dark that they look for victims or weakness. And if they think there's any kind of baggage or a family dispute, they find, for me, they couldn't find anything on me because I've never broke the law and I never hurt anybody. So they had to try to pick on my husband's kids, I believe, because the mom was always taking my husband to court even before I met him, because she left the kids, but then she wanted money. So then she came back and got them after they got like in fourth grade and second grade, when they started developing a mind of their own, and she took them away from their dad. So they knew that there had been that tension between Bob and his ex and her new husband. And I think they just look for an opening to get in and play with your mind. But these people have been in my head for so long, it's a wonder I'm not completely cuckoo. And they told me years later, you were beauty and innocence too powerful to resist, and we just wanted to take it. I hope all this reverses. I hope God reverses all this and he punishes every one of them for every single thing they did. Because they deserve it. I'm tired of suffering. I'm watching the world go downhill. And, something needs to change. But they're in my brain tonight and they're trying to destroy me completely because I found peace. And when I find peace is when they attack me the most. When Simon Marsden sent me an invite to France, they were actually killing me. I had gone to a psychiatrist locally because they were just making me have such bad head pain. And I remember he tried to do an exam on me, and he tried to get me to move my eyes to the side, and I couldn't do it. That's how brain dead they had me. And now they tell me, haven't you noticed the last 6 months you're starting to mess up in your posts and all this? They love to rub it in because they're sadists. And I think half of them are vampires. But the sad part is I think they're putting people in the police force and into a lot of different cities. Not all the police, but some of them. And they're training them in how to kill people and perform rituals. From what I'm seeing, a lot of the people that have been threatening me lately, they have skulls. But they're into worshiping the devil. And they put devil things at their site and witchcraft and voodoo. And I just think the devil is taking over in this country through these weapons, through cyber world, through possessed, stupid people that have been either programmed or they're just criminally insane. And I think this is, we've passed the criminal era. Now we're just in the devil era. And things aren't going to improve because these people have no conscience and they're evil.